Hello and welcome to today's lecture. Now in this lecture we are going to look at the examples based on majority of rearrangement reactions. I have written some 7 examples. There are some more to follow. The first example is when alpha pinene is treated with HCl. You get this more substituted chloride. That is because of the Markovnikov's addition, because you tend to get more substituted carbonium ion, and which is being attacked by Cl minus. Second thing or second transformation is heat, where Cl goes off, this ring expands, and this pinene becomes borynyl chloride. So the positive charge will be here. Once this goes off and this comes here, positive charge will be here, and that is being attacked by Cl. So that is the transformation. We'll write down these steps immediately after this. The second reaction is based upon the pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. Now protonation of one of these two, because they are chemically equivalent, loss of water molecule followed by the migration of one of the phenyl ring, and then the loss of proton, that is the pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. Now this one, acid chloride azide, so this is going to be your Curtius rearrangement. Isocyanate is there and the workup is same. Isocyanate attacked by water loses carbon dioxide and primary amine is formed. Then this one is the oxime, wherein you are having two rings, one is phenyl, the other one is substitution at para position, and naturally the basic is this is leaving group, the group anti to this has to migrate, and therefore phenyl ring will migrate with the expulsion of or this group or removal of this group, and here you will get water molecule addition, and then the tautomerism will furnish this amide. Then next example, the fifth one is ketone is treated with per acid. You get ester. So this is your classical Bayer-Willeger rearrangement, wherein oxygen incorporation will be there, and this will become trifluoroacetic acid. So this will undergo reduction, this will undergo oxidation, addition of oxygen, removal of oxygen. That is how it will go. This is Somlett-Hauser or rearrangement. Nitrogen lone pair attacks. The Cl goes off, and then Cl minus attacks, and you open that three-membered aziridine ring, and that is how you get this. The last example is Wolf rearrangement, wherein the diazo ketone is treated with photolyte, and you get ketin, which on workup can give you the acid, the homologous acid to be precise. Okay. Now let us write down the mechanism for each step, and of course we have to do some more examples after this. So just quickly we'll put the mechanism for each step. So for the first one, let me clear this and write the step. So this will be H and Cl. The pi bond attacks at electron deficient center, and as a consequence of this, you will be having, say, this is the more stable carbonium ion, and then Cl minus will attack here, and you will get this chloride as a result of Markovnikov's addition. This goes off, and what you have, you will have positive charge here, because that is heterolytic cleavage of carbon chlorine bond. This bond migrates here, and subsequently you will have a so we can write it on the other side also, because it is just a flipping of the molecule. Now this Cl minus can attack here, and you get this compound. So that is your first example wherein this example is Mirren-Wagner rearrangement, wherein the carbonium ion is formed and which is the cause for the skeletal rearrangement in the molecule. The second example, second example is based upon the, I'll just draw it here. The top portion may take little longer time for drawing, so let us put it beneath. Protonation of one of the OH, loss of this, the immediate step, then migration of this ring. So eventually what you will have, you have a plus charge here, CH3 PH PH, and then loss of plus, so you will be having COCH3 here and the other groups are as it is. So this is pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. Now the participation of phenyl ring you can show with the pi electrons also. You can show that bridge and so on, but I am just showing it in simpler way. Okay, that bridge can be shown and that will be another detail. Now acid chloride is treated with sodium azide. So this is the acid chloride which is shown over there. Sodium azide NaN3, let me put it the entire structure. This is NaN3. So you'll be having CO N Na N2 plus. Then this comes back, this entire ring comes here, this goes out. So eventually what you have a, just have to shift this ring here, rest of the things are same, and this one when interacts with water can give you the intermediate which collapses into primary amine and CO2. This is there. That is how the mechanism can be shown. So finally you will end up with the amine with one carbon less. So that is the classical Curtius rearrangement wherein azides are involved and the other reaction conditions are similar to the normal reactions. Now then comes the I am drawing the rings here now. Let me draw it like this. There is one benzene ring here. NO PCl2 something, some leaving group. Now this is anti to leaving group, so this goes off and now this ring migrates here. So eventually what you have CN and this pH I am putting, and then this ring, this carbon will be deficient along with the other ring. Although this has got greater migrating aptitude, but this is anti and the group anti to leaving group migrates, and then it is a matter of addition of water. And finally what you have, this is OH, this is going to be NH, PH. or initially you can show the, now let me put one more step here. Positive charge is taken up by oxygen, that is first thing. Conjugate base will help in stabilizing this charge, and finally there is a ketoenol tautomerism. So let me put it this way, NPH, the other ring is intact, because, and then this is the ketoenol, that is how you get the final compound. Okay, now moving on to next example. Now this is your classical Beckmann rearrangement, wherein the oxime OH is transformed into some leaving group which is better than OH, and that is how the reaction can take place. Now the other example is wherein the leaving group is there. Now only heat is there, so no other reagents are there. So as a result of heat, what happens is you get the formation of aziridine ring. Now this aziridinium ion is having three membered ring, a highly strained system, and naturally the strain is relieved when this bond breaks in this way. So that is how you get six membered ring, because this is CH2 is incorporated in the ring, and that is how you get the five membered becomes six membered. So that is your rearrangement of the, which is catalyzed by heat. The next one is to, when you heat it, this will give rise to, now this comes back, comes here, and you get the ring contraction. Now this ring contraction gives ketene. So this is Wolff rearrangement, when diazoketones are heated, and this one, if I treat it with water, you get the homologous acid in this case. So like Wolff type reaction, you can say this one COOH, that is how the reaction take place. Okay, now there are five more examples, so let us finish them, and hopefully from next lecture we can start with oxidation reduction chapter. That is again in the important chapter, so let us finish the example today. NaOBr. Now here this is your classical Hoffmann degradation, because this is amide. So NaOBr is prepared from NaOH and bromine. So this goes off, this opens up. So what you have, you got ONa and CONH2. Now once you have primary amide, this primary amide can react with NaOBr. We have already shown that. So this nitrogen can attack here, this goes off, and eventually you got NHBr. This is being attacked by OH, this comes here, this entire group migrates here, and Br goes off. So what you have, I'll just put it as it appears. Now this will be attached to nitrogen and then the isocyanate. If I break it, what I'll get, if I hydrolyze, it will be OH and this will be NH2. So that is how the product is obtained after the addition of water to this. So that is the classical Hoffman degradation of amide, wherein one carbon is lost. Now let us do some more examples. This is hydroxamic acid which is treated with pyrrolidone sulfonyl chloride. That is first step, and second step is base, and you are going to get R N C double bond O isocyanate, and then it is a workup part. So first of all, the transformation of bad leaving group into good leaving group, that is how it is possible with pyrrolidone sulfonyl chloride. So let me put that structure here. This is your pyrrolidone sulfonyl chloride. This acts as a sink, and R C O N H O T S. Now T S is that entire group. Now when base is there, base will abstract this. You will have R C O N minus O T S. This is very good leaving group. So when this comes here, R migrates, O T S goes off, and that is how you get the isocyanate. Now once isocyanate is there, the further workup is easy, and that is the normal workup with water or alcohol or amine to get the different compounds of your choice. Next example. Now this is little different example, so let me put, this is NCOOH, and then this is the compound, and now you got NaOH to react with. Now this is your classical Fabreski rearrangement. So the job of NaOH is to abstract this proton, and it will knock out the bromide. This is carbonyl. Now this is that cyclopropanone type intermediate, and finally the OH minus will attack here, and the ring can open in either way to give you the products. So either this will open up or this will open up, and that is how you get the two products depending upon the ring opening in this case. There are two more examples. We'll quickly complete those two. Alpha allocator, whenever you see, it is your Fabreski rearrangement. So first of all, there has to be a proton which is necessary for this kind of reactions, and now you got to have two rings on either side. So let me put the ring at as it appears on both the side, and then OH minus can attack. The ring can open this way or this way. Accordingly, you'll get two products. Now that is your classical Fabreski rearrangement reaction. One more example is there. Let us finish that also. Now this ketone is treated with perbenzoic acid. So I am putting perbenzoic acid directly here, COPH. So this is perbenzoic acid, as we have already shown, OH, CH3, and then, or let me put CH3 here, and then it is OOCOPH. It comes here, this entire group migrates, this goes off. So what you will have, CH3, CO, O, and then this ring, right? Plus PHCOH. So this has got greater migrating aptitude, so this goes off and migrates, and that is how you get the compound. The driving force is the presence of this leaving group. This group goes out as a neutral molecule, benzoic acid, and that is how you get the formation of ester in this case, because you are working with aliphatic acyclic compound, so naturally esters are obtained. If it is cyclic compound, then lactone is obtained, and so on. Okay, now that's all for today. So next time we'll continue with the oxidation reduction reaction. Now if any questions are there, you are welcome, you can post them, I'll solve. And in revision type paper solving or some important questions also, I'll post on the group so that you can solve them at home. For today, thank you very much for your patience hearing. Thank you.